regulators. We regulate any stealing of his property. We're damn good, too. But you can't be any geek off the street. You gotta be handy with the steel, if you know what I mean. Earn your keep.
Regulators! Mount up!
It was a clear black night, a clear white moon. Warren G was on the streets, trying to consume some skirts for the E, so I could get some phones. Rolling in my ride, chilling all alone.
Just hit the east side of the LBC, on a mission trying to find Mr. Warren G. Seen a car full of girls, ain't no need to tweak.
Buy this car to drive to work, drive to work to pay for this car. Buy this car to drive to work, drive to work.
Welcome to Albrook Road. I'm Jordan, and today we're going to talk about more impeachment stuff thingies happening. But first, please consider, please share, and hopefully consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery GoFundMe link in the description box. Click that link, right-click it, copy, right-click paste in your favorite social media platforms. Do it now. Devin's Journey to Recovery GoFundMe link in the description box. All right. So as you can see here from AP, the House is working swiftly to try to oust President Trump from office, first attempting to get the Vice President and Cabinet to invoke the 25th Amendment, read the text of the impeachment, blah, 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 incitement of insurrection. Okay, and in the top part it says, Democrats say the House will consider the impeachment of President Trump on Wednesday, 1 week after an angry mob of his supporters invaded the Capitol. The Democrats' article of impeachment will charge Trump with incitement of insurrection. Incitement of insurrection. All right, so. I mean, what have these guys done? And I saw, I was live when, I wasn't there when it initially popped off with the protest and the insurrection was happening, right? I wasn't live when it jumped off, but I went live just in time to see, oh, Ilhan Omar is considering drawing up impeachment, blah, 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 papers, articles of impeachment in the Cori Bush thing. And it's like, We all have this sense in regards to the establishment people that have been there for years. Like, okay, we know they're not shit. We already understand those people are not shit. They're not there to try to make the world better. They're bullshit. In regards to the squad, as in these new faces that are supposed to change things around and all that, they're coming in to try and change the system. Work within the system to change it from the inside. It's like, what have they done? I mean, seriously, what have they done? Someone's going to tell me about some bill, some resolution to, I don't know, give the homeless an extra piece of bread or something. Although I get why that's important. It's like, yeah, you could have did something way bigger than that. It's like, oh, how can I get these greedy creepers, or how can I get them out of the way so we can actually help people? It's like, well, it's pretty simple. You expose their crimes. If they're creepers, they're sure as hell committing crimes, life crimes. And all I have to do is point them out. But what are we impeaching things on? Whatever goes trending on Twitter. What are things AOC gets in a ruckus about? Things that are trending. If it isn't something that's already in mainstream, pop culture, whatever, it's like, why aren't you louder about it? You have, I mean, what does she have? Let's look.
Let's look at this.
I'm gonna take time out to do this. AOC. Damn. 11.4 million fucking followers. 11.4 million followers. Boy, this looks like... That looks like something. She looks like she's about to talk about war crimes. Looks like she's about to explain the decades, actually I would say centuries, of crimes committed by the U.S. government and other governments. Looks like that's what she's about to do. Clearly, right? That's what her whole page is about, right? There's Mehdi Hasan. He's not quite Modi. He is Mehdi, though. He's mediocre. He's mediocre. There's that guy. I think he's a grifter. Inaction will embolden him. Are you fighting a person or are you fighting corruption? Nothing about this person tells me that they fight corruption. The character you play seems like just a walking meme as opposed to a force for good. Regardless if you believe goodness is objective or subjective, you have to, like, you'd have to know it on an intellectual level. It's like, you don't see that fight from her, right? You don't see the intention to do away with bad things in the world. I don't see that. I see mealy-mouthed lightweights. Or psyops. Either your character was carefully constructed and you're just some sort of creeper. Or you are one of the weakest humans on the planet. It's not difficult for AOC to use her platform. I'm going to call a conference that I want. I'm going to broadcast it on the internet so everyone can see. It's not going to... I need everyone to show up because this isn't going to be some boring political lecture about blah, blah. This is going to be me ranting about what this government does, what happens here. I'm going to tell everyone about it. But no. Instead, we get a... potential hero of the people running away from a Max Blumenthal interview talking about Venezuela. That's what we get. That's next level weak. How intelligent do you have to be to say, oh, there's a problem happening in the world and I'm a elected representative? Maybe I should listen to this problem. I hear you, but write a post-it note to my staff, you know, Jamal, my staff, my secretary, my assistant, write him a post-it note and I'll get back to you when I can, if my team lets me, if Nancy lets me. Unfucking real. So, naturally, this is what they draw up articles of impeachment for, or the Ukraine phone call. Meanwhile, you have them dead to rights on war crimes. Dead to rights on war crimes. They don't fucking look at it. Unreal. Unfucking real. And guess what? You don't even need to draw up impeachment papers or anything for that. I brought this up with people, you know, who make more of a case about strategy. Like, oh, we need allies like AOC and the squad and whoever so that one day, you know, our numbers will overwhelm the establishment and then we can start getting things passed. And I'm like, well, how many years do you need to point out a war crime? You can do that along the way. right? Because I think they're mostly when I get these strategists, I think they're talking mostly about things like healthcare or minimum wages or, you know, social benefits for people. And it's like, okay, I get it. That's an argument about which strategy can we go about to make things more efficient that helps everybody. But then there's like bombs and shit. What do we do with that? How should that be handled? Can't that shit be taken care of, like, overnight? It's one thing to say, oh, how long could we get this healthcare plan established? And it's another thing to say, how long does it take to not bomb a school bus full of children? How much time does it take to not do that? How much time does it take to not be taking money from whatever, Pfizer? How long does that take? So the strategy argument flies out the window once you bring up things like bombs going off. It flies out the fucking window. There is no argument for that. The best counter is going to be some sort of Noam Chomsky shit where it's, we need to protect the Kurds in northern Syria. So we need to leave guys with, you know, AR-15s or whatever they have, M-16s. We need to leave those guys out there in the field, endangering them and other people. How about Trump just pardoning war criminals left and right? There's no case to be drawn up there. It's his legal right. Unreal. 11 million followers, and you do nothing with it. Well, I don't want to say nothing, but you essentially do nothing. Because that one's just right there. There is no gray area about it. Here's the area of the world. Here's the labels on the bombs. And here's the results of the bomb. How much effort does that take? It takes courage, for sure. But how much, like, physical effort does that take? Not much. Since Trump's being banned, doesn't that give you an opening? I'm sure I'm sure AOC has access to all these social platforms, and she's not banned at all. Why don't she do it there? She can go live on Twitch, YouTube, Twitter, all of it simultaneously, and tell people about what's happening in the world. But, you know, someone called her a bitch. She had a bad day, so she forgot to talk about the war crimes. But she has time for this. I'm sure she has time for this, for drawing up articles of impeachment, which is once again another pop culture topic. Trump and impeachment is pop culture. That's what it's turned into. I don't see anything really serious about this. It's for lame brains to gossip over, rather than looking for like an actual solution or result for anything. Get rid of Trump and have Pence. Wow. Changed the world there. Get rid of Pence, put in Biden. Whoa. The world's changing, isn't it? Unreal. Alright, that's it for me. Please subscribe if you like. Comment. Agree. Disagree. I mean, is AOC capable of doing more? Is Ilhan Omar capable of doing more? Are any of these people, is any of the House Democrats that are drawing up articles of impeachment, Cori Bush, whoever, newly elected people, whatever, are they capable of doing what I just said, running a PR campaign showing, hey, this is what happens over here in the world? Just speaking real to people. Don't make it some boring political thing. Just be blatantly honest about it with as many people as you can, and then keep going until as many people get it as possible. I don't think that's that difficult. Give me her, like, hey, AOC, give me your account for a day, and I'll do more than you did in, what, 4 years? And I basically guarantee that. You know, obviously a meteor could hit the Earth or whatever, but I essentially guarantee that. Like, shit will change. Give me one day. All right. Don't forget to donate, or hopefully donate, and obviously share Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. With all that said, give this video a thumbs down. Say you wanna get him.